Well, it was a fun night in Sioux Falls at Heritage Court at the Sanford Pentagon, but it ends in a loss for the University of South Dakota. They fall 75-61 to UNLV, and it was a back-and-forth first half, Greg, in this building as USD really came to play in this game. Even when UNLV tried to open up, they got it up to about 7 points. Coyotes came right back, got the lead, but that athleticism and that just that athletic ability that UNLV brought to the table really helped them open things up. They were up 11 at the half, and it really shone through tonight for them.
Yeah, it did, and I think they used that to their advantage, created some separation in the last 6 minutes of the first half. Credit to them on the defensive end, and I think USD will learn a lot from that, how to handle that type of pressure and not allow that separation to take place heading into halftime.
Well, let's take a look at the first half highlights from this game. And it starts with Rashad Vaughn, one of the premier freshmen in the entire country.
Yeah, in the country. Outside, here you see him inside with the jump hook. And then Tyler Larson answered a couple of different ways. Here you see he attacks on the baseline, goes to the reverse layup. Nice finish. And then at the same time, Eric Robertson, I thought, had a very productive game throughout the course of the evening.
Yeah, Eric Robertson had done very well early in the season. He struggled a little bit more offensively and defensively, frankly, for the last couple of games. But he was back to his normal self tonight, and he provided a big spark for this team when they needed it, because Trey Burnett, one of the starters, got some early foul trouble. They needed somebody to come in and pick up some of that offensive slack, and Eric Robertson certainly was that guy. But that last shot before the half that you just saw from Patrick McCaw, that one hurt. That one took a lot of the electricity out of the building.
It did push it from 8 to 11 after a turnover, just the worst possible sequence of events. But at the same time, USD kind of regrouped. They had an opportunity in the second half to close the gap. It just wasn't as easy as they'd hoped.
And the Coyotes came out in that second half, and they struck first. Brandon Boss, who had a very nice night offensively, he gets the first bucket in that second 20 minutes.
Yeah, Boss, I thought, was good attacking the basket all night. Didn't rely on jumpers. But there you see the freshman for UNLV with a tough finish. Casper Bauer did come alive a little bit in the second half. Only 5 3-pointers on the night for USD. Casper Bauer with a couple of them in the second half. Senior for UNLV with a big shot. Tyler Larson answers as well.
Yeah, USD struggled from the perimeter all night long. Eric Robertson hits the baseline jumper there. UNLV had opened it up to 15 points a couple of different times. Christian Wood, a big part of that for UNLV. Casey Casper Bauer trying to give the team a spark. Down the stretch, he was 2 of 8 from downtown. Not his normal success rate from outside. Eric Robertson threw it down there as the Coyotes actually climbed back within 8 there in the latter stat. About 3 minutes left to play in the game, but UNLV just able to pull away and just kind of keep the Coyotes at an arm's length all night. And as we take a look at the final stats, brought to you by the Vermilion Area Chamber and Development Company, 2 of 17 from downtown on the night for USD. That's a big part of their game that just wasn't there.
It really was. And, you know, the turnover, there's not a big discrepancy, but when you look at the points off turnovers, UNLV 26 points off turnovers, USD 9 points off turnovers. There's a difference in the game, Jay.
And one impressive thing I will say in the loss, the fact that given the fact that UNLV had so much more size and overall so much more athleticism, USD won the battle on the boards. That's not easy to do when you're playing a lineup as small as they are.
No, it's not. That kind of points towards heart and toughness and desire. And you don't worry so much about size differential. And that's a credit to USD, something they can take out of this game and say, we can rebound with anybody. We don't care how big or how small we are.
Coyotes fall again 75-61 tonight, and they drop to 3-8 on the season. UNLV improves to 6-2. USD back in action Thursday night down in Vermilion. They haven't gotten a chance to play on their home floor a whole lot, so I know they're looking forward to that. They are hosting Montana State out of the Big Sky Conference. 7:30, the tip-off for that one. That game, again, live right here on Midco Sports Network. For Greg Steeman, I'm Jay Elson. For the rest of our Midco SN crew, thanks for watching.